Hello, this is John Squire with Legend Seeds. I am the alfalfa specialist for the company, and I want to introduce to you what I call the Ag Squire Alfalfa Moment. This will be a series of video clips and presentations to share with you matters of alfalfa management, variety selection, and how to improve the operation of your alfalfa system on your farm. So today I want to talk with you about this alfalfa selection and alfalfa selection considerations. Legend Seeds offers 6 alfalfa products. And so you ask, well, which one of them is the best? And to that I respond, well, what are you looking for? They each have their place to fit, and that's why we offer 6 alfalfas. And there are various alfalfas that would fit a wider range of operations, but then there are a few alfalfas that have a more narrow selection. I'm not going to go through the alfalfa varieties that we offer. Rather, I'm going to talk about selection criteria, what you want to consider when you're looking for an alfalfa. So to that, why do we offer 6 alfalfas? We want to be able to match an alfalfa with your management objectives. So if you consider what you're doing, are you looking for, I'll call it just alfalfa, or just looking for something run-of-the-mill, or are you serious about your alfalfa production? Do you want to step it up and maximize your return on investment and get the best alfalfa that you can? And is any one of those answers right or wrong? It's really about matching the right variety or alfalfa product to what you're looking for. So with that, I say, what are you looking for? We offer potential. When we sell seed, we sell potential. And when we talk about potential, we say on average, we would expect this kind of a response with your crop. So if you look at the picture here, we've got 2 alfalfa varieties represented. And you can see one, it appears one is better than the other. Well, they're different varieties selected for different purposes. And that regrowth suggests on the one that looks better, it says that suggests that's a better variety. So let's help you maximize and that return on your investment by selecting the better variety. And what does that mean? Let's place the right variety on your operation. Well, to that, we need to ask, well, what are your growing conditions? How long of a season do you have? Do you cut 3 or 4 times? Or do you maybe even try to cut 5 times? What's your soil drainage like? What kind of pest pressure do you have? These are questions we need to answer to help place the right variety on your farm. To illustrate the value of placing the right variety, in here is a variety that's highly resistant to aphanomyces race 2 right in the center of the picture, and on either side of it are they don't have that high expression of resistance. And so if you have soil that's maybe a little bit heavier, poorly drained, this is something that you would want to consider with this trait in it. And the variety that Legend Seeds offers with high resistance to aphanomyces race 2 is Leyenda. So that's something you could consider. What other things would you want to consider? Well, you want to consider fall dormancy, winter hardiness, disease resistance, whether you want to Roundup Ready or Harvex or alfalfa. Those kind of things come into play when you're considering what you're going to plant. You need to recognize that this is going to be an investment for 3 to 5 years. And yes, maybe the seed costs is high, that initial seeding, but that's for the life of the stand, for 3-5 years, and you want to be able to get the proper stand and maximize that return over that period of the effective stand life. So you need to consider the potential of that seed and don't get hung up so much on the price of the seed. Price often reflects value that we place on something, and when we put a higher price on it, we consider that it has a higher value. And so that's something that I would say, don't get blinded by that. Yes, it's a consideration, but don't get blinded by it, because a difference of even $50 in a price of seed is really less than if you have that stand life for 3 years, that's $15 a year, and that's nothing. And if you look at it per acre, it's even less than that. So price of seed should not be a huge factor, and don't let that get you hung up. Secondly is, what opportunity are you looking at with your alfalfa? Here's an illustration of a Roundup alfalfa managed and sprayed with Roundup, and you can see the pure stand. This is after they took before they even took the first cutting, and you can see that it's pure alfalfa as opposed to what's on the fringe here with some weeds there. Here's another illustration, similar alfalfa, same alfalfa, but they managed it with Post Plus and Pursuit. So this does not have the spectrum of weed activity, and hence you can see the white cockle coming through there. And then the real contrast is the Roundup alfalfa versus sprayed with Roundup versus Roundup alfalfa, but no, not sprayed with any herbicide. So what does this give you, that potential and opportunity? It gives you the opportunity to have better weed control, better stand establishment, and better quality hay from the beginning. So these things are what we try to explain to you and work with you on, is giving you opportunity for maximizing the return on your investment, placing the right variety on your farm, and helping you be satisfied with what you're looking for. So with that, simply keep in mind the potential that's in the seed and how we can help answer your management objectives by placing the right variety on your farm. With that, this has been an Ag Squire Alfalfa Moment. Happy harvesting. Thank you.